Children, in this video, I'll continue with chapter number 4. Yes, functions of commercial bank, and that too, the primary functions I'll continue with. Today's first topic in it is credit creation. Banks undertake the activity of credit creation to ensure that the supply of money in the economy fulfills the demand for money. Yes, both of them should be balanced. Banks create money from the deposits, thereby add to the supply of money in the economy. When credit creation of bank increases, the supply of money increases. And when credit creation of bank decreases, yes, the supply of money reduces. Now, people deposit money in their respective bank accounts. As per the central bank guidelines, the commercial banks are required to maintain a portion of total deposits in the form of cash reserves. With the help of past experiences, the commercial banks now know that not all the depositors will turn up for withdrawal at the same day. Consequently, the commercial banks lend the remaining portion of the total deposits to general public in the form of credit, loans and advances. It is the second portion of the total deposits that is responsible for credit creation. The process of credit creation can be better understood with the help of following numerical example. Now, for simplicity, let us assume that the entire commercial banking system is a single unit called banks. Suppose initially the public deposited rupees 1000 with the banks. Students, please take a note that deposits in the form of initial public savings with the banks are called primary deposits. The banks kept a portion of these deposits with themselves as cash reserves and extends the rest as loans to the borrowers. Let us assume it to be 20%. So, we can say that out of primary deposits of rupees 1000, banks will keep aside rupees 200 and lend rupees 800 as loan. Now it is obvious that the borrower has to open an account with the same bank or another branch in order to deposit the check of loan. When the check is credited in the new account, it becomes derived deposits. From this derived deposits, the bank can create still another loan for the third person. The third person's loan becomes one more deposit for the bank. Thus, a bank can create several deposits from a primary deposits. One thing more, students, over here, it is supposed that all the transactions are undertaken via bank, are routed by bank. Now, the table related to credit creation is on your screen. The formula for credit creation is primary deposit into 1 upon cash reserve ratio. No bank can lend the full amount of a deposit. From every deposit, the bank has to keep aside some portion of money in the form of cash reserves, which is known as cash reserve ratio. Thus, they can lend the remaining money only. Besides, when borrower withdraws the loan amount from his or her account and spends it, there is greater circulation, that is, greater supply of money in the economy. Now, In other words, primary deposits of rupees 1000 can create a money supply of rupees 5000, and it can be said that a new credit of rupees 4000 is created. Apart from this, when customers withdraw more money than the deposited amount from their current account, it is called overdraft facility, and this also leads to credit creation. Students, I hope I am clear to you with it. Now we move on to the next one, that is interbanking transactions. As the name itself suggests, over here the transactions are undertaken between the banks. Banks provide short term and long term credit to one another from time to time. Yes, credit for a short time period and long time period. Short term credit is provided by one bank to another through the central bank, and it is called call money. The interest rate on call money is called the call money rate. Students, now I move on to the secondary, that is the other functions of commercial banks. The very first one in it is agency and utility services. A bank provides various utility and agent banking services to its customers. For example, a bank can act as a mediating agent by providing a letter of credit to the exporter on behalf of the importer. This is what you have already studied. Banks also provide underwriting services to various businesses. Underwriting services means banks taking financial risk for fees. Banks also provide facilities to its customers to pay the tax challans, to pay the tax to the government. Banks also provide safe deposit vaults on rent to its customers. Yes, safe deposit vaults of different sizes are available in banks. Obviously, these safe deposit vaults are used to safely store, to safely keep our precious jewelry, our documents, etc. Banks provide microfinance facilities for very small businesses, which are important for development of communities. Yes, microfinance, as the name itself suggests, the finance over here will be very less amount of loan. When some payments are to be made with foolproof security, banks provide service to the payer by issuing draft or pay order. Now, I move on to the second one, that is provide various facilities with changing times. Now, we all know that there has been a continuous expansion and diversification in the functions and the activities and services of the bank. There have been many changes in the services provided by banks. For example, the ATM card. Another example, the facility of RTGS. Now, in present times, electronic transfer of money from the account of one customer to that of another customer of any bank is done. Yes, it is done without using cash or check. With the help of facilities like NEFT, that is National Electronic Fund Transfer, and RTGS, that is Real Time Gross Settlement. Now, in RTGS, students, you will be given a form and you are supposed to fill all the details of the form, and your money will be transferred within a span of 3 to 4 hours. Students, in RTGS, the payer does not give cash or check in physical form to pay. I hope you have got it, student. Both these are possible because of CORE banking, that is Centralized Online Real-Time Exchange. Besides, customers can get various details of their accounts as well as make payments, buy goods, book tickets, etc. on the computer or mobile phone through internet banking and mobile banking app. Yes, with the help of internet banking, with the help of different apps, we can easily make the payments. For example, electricity bill payment, we can book the tickets also with the help of internet banking and mobile banking apps. Banks also provide safe deposit vaults and facilities of Demat account. Demat account is dematerialized account. Now this account is used for shares, debentures, bonds, etc. This is an account where shares, debentures, bonds, etc. can be held in electronic form, which is easier than holding them in physical form. Yes, in physical form, they may be stolen, but over here, there won't be any such problem. Students, I am done with the secondary functions. Now I move on to our next topic, that is presence of commercial banks in India. Commercial banks in India operate in public as well as in private sectors. Yes, commercial banks are of both types, public as well as the private one. After the economic reforms of 1991, that is liberalization, privatization and globalization, foreign banks have entered the private sectors. Yes, the permission was given. Besides, there are financial companies which functions like banks in the unorganized and organized money markets of India. Unorganized money markets means, yes, the loans taken from money lenders, shops, etc. And there also is the existence of cooperative banks. Cooperative banks means over here, the main objective of such kind of banks is to provide financial assistance, financial aid to economically weaker sections of the society. Over here, their main aim is not to earn profit. But by the official definition of banks in India, only those companies which are listed in the second schedule of RBI Act 1934 are established accordingly, are called scheduled banks and are real banks. All rules and regulations of Reserve Bank of India apply to these banks. Now, on the screen, you will find the chart that is giving or telling us about the classification of scheduled banks. Students, with this, I'm done. With this video, we will continue with the chapter. Till that time, yes, you all know, you're supposed to take care of yourself. Thank you.